This is Microsoft Security Essentials, how to download, install and configure video tutorial. Hello, and thanks for joining me for this tutorial. My name is Vadim Mikhailenko from howtoanalyzedata.net, and I'm here to help you out to make smart business decisions and answer your questions about information technology tools. In this video, we're going to look at how you can download Microsoft Security Essentials, how you can install it and configure the software. And also, we're going to look at how you can optimize the execution of this antivirus tool. The best way to get location of the installation files is to go to Google and type the name of the product, as you probably always do. Microsoft Security Essentials. And there's a link that comes up for download of Microsoft Security Essentials. And you just pick download the software. You have to know which version you have. And most likely you need x86 version. This is for Intel-based machines that run on the Intel processor. And once you picked it, and we'll just pick run option for this download. What Microsoft does, they do a security scan, they check to make sure that this is the non-infected file. Once the scanning is continuous, you see the user account control message, which allows confirmation from the user. So this is the wizard for Microsoft Security Essential installation. You just select the choices. If you want to join the program, that's fine. I already had the firewall turned on, so that's not an issue. And it goes through the installation. One thing I was going to mention is if you are interested in getting the free course from howtoanalyzedata.net, please make sure to go to the website and send me a question about the tool that you'd like to cover in the step-by-step tutorial. And if your question is selected, I'll contact you and get you the coupon for the free course of your choice. So I'm going to pause this video and get back to this when the installation is complete. So the installation of Microsoft Security Essentials is complete, and it prompts me to do the restart of the computer now. So I'm going to click restart and wait when it comes back. Again, I'm going to pause this video so you don't have to wait until the restart finishes. So the computer just finished rebooting, and I am going to go and launch Microsoft Security Essentials. It's on the task bar, in the status bar. Available as an icon. I'm just going to click open and walk you through the GUI, graphical user interface. So the green checkbox indicates that your PC is up to date with the protection. We have real-time protection on, and this is the virus and spyware definition is up to date. And what happens if you wait for a couple days and your computer stays off for a couple days? This becomes orange and then could become red if it stayed for too long. So it's important to watch for this indication, even though the product is designed such a way that it automatically goes and checks Microsoft site for the recent software update and virus definition updates. From this screen, you can also click and execute scans. So you can do a quick scan, full scan, or custom scan. And you just select the option that you'd like to do and click the Scan Now button. Also from here you can change the scan schedule. By default it comes with the Sunday 2 a.m. check and limits CPU usage to 50%. So what I'd recommend you do, you pick a day, and sometimes I pick the day when I just keep my computer on and go and leave the workstation. So if it's your home workstation, might be good to do it start maybe Monday at 9 a.m. right? So this is certainly you left from home, you're in the office, and the scanning will start. And if it's your office workstation, maybe it's the opposite is true. So when you leave the office, or maybe right before the weekend, maybe Friday night, so Friday 8 p.m. Would be the good time to start it. And obviously you need to click Save Settings, and Security Essentials asks for confirmation, and it commits the changes, and this is the series of your new settings. On other tabs you can also look at what type of definitions you're using. For example, this was created in April 30th, 2014. The history shows if any of the malware was found, and if there's anything that needs your attention. If any items are found, you'll be offered different actions based on the severity of the issue. If you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, How to Analyze Data. And you can also check out the free training courses at udemy.com. Just search for How to Analyze Data on Udemy, or search for Vadim Mikhailenko at udemy.com. And if you know a better way to do it, please let me and everybody else know. Just leave comments and feedback. I always appreciate your feedback. And this is the goal of this video, to share the information with you so you can learn something and I can learn something new. So please don't hesitate to send me a note and let me know about the better way of doing things. Thank you very much, and see you next time.